Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. Now, it's always very exciting when you order some new telescope kit and it arrives in the post. So today we're going to do an unboxing video. Here's the box, Skywatcher, be amazed. Hopefully we will. So inside we've got a Skymax 150 Pro Maksutov telescope. Let's take a look. Okay, so what have we got? Well, the box is around 60 centimetres long and 25 centimetres deep. It's got the usual handle with care markings you might expect for sending optical equipment. If we open it up, firstly you can see some packing material, so it's some polystyrene foam. And then we can see that inside the box we've got the tube, the optical tube assembly, and we've got a cardboard box. So putting that to one side, we remove the tube. So it's wrapped in a plastic bag and some paper. And there you can see the Skywatcher 150 Maksutov tube assembly. I'd say first impressions, it's a nice finish on the actual tube itself. It's sort of sparkly black finish. It comes with a lens cap on the front and what looks like a 2-inch fitting on the back. This one's got a Smith Cassegrain thread. The later models have got this thread. The usual standard focuser knob. Coming around this side, we've got a standard bracket to attach a finder scope. And you'll see the labelling there to say that there is shot optical glass inside this scope, as you find in lots of Skywatcher Pro telescopes. So what would I say? It's pretty substantial actually. I think it's a little bit bigger than I was expecting it to be. Previously I've had a Celestron C6 scope, which is the same aperture, but this is much heavier. I think this tube assembly is about 5.5 kilos and it's a bit longer than the C6 and it feels really quite substantial. It's got a standard Vixen dovetail plate running along the whole length of the tube. Okay, put that down. What else is in the box? As I said, it comes with a box of extra bits. Let's have a look. So the first item, 28mm multi-coated. So this is the eyepiece that comes with the scope. So it's nicely wrapped. Here it is, 28mm multi-coated. It's got a bit of a cheap label stuck on the side here. I think that's going to come off fairly soon. Otherwise, quite a nice finish. It's got a big rubber eye shield, which from reading about these, you can move it in and out to give the right comfortable position. 2-inch eyepiece, comes with covers. We'll give that a try another time, see what sort of performance we get from it. Carrying on, inside the box, got a diagonal. Again, it's nicely wrapped. So this is a standard 2-inch diagonal. Quite a lightweight feel. Certainly a lot of metal. Taking off the lens caps, you can see, hopefully, you can see the mirror. And also, you should be able to see that it comes with a standard barrel size adapter, so you can put a 2-inch eyepiece into the diagonal, or you can use 1¼-inch diameter accessories eyepieces. So that all seems pretty good. Quite useful that you get the whole set of accessories with this scope. So just removing that again, we can see that you can put the two together. I'd say it's a fairly cheap diagonal in a way. I can't judge the performance yet, but it doesn't have a compression ring as you might find on a higher end model. It's just got the two screws, but certainly get you started, no problem, I'm sure. Okay, what else is in the box? Right, looks like the last item is finder scope. So there you go. I think it's certainly a 50mm objective. I'm not sure if it's an 8x5 or 9x5. 9x50 rather. Nicely finished. Comes with the same finish on the tube as you have on the telescope tube assembly. And as you might expect, it's going to connect easily onto side of the tube assembly. So if we put it all together, take off the cover, put in the diagonal, tighten up the screws, here comes the eyepiece. So this is 28mm, so it's quite a wide angle eyepiece, quite a low power eyepiece. Okay, so that is the whole assembly. So this is what you get in the box. I'd say it feels very solid. Looking forward to using it. Let's have a look at the front, I guess the business end. So there you go, you can see the silver from the secondary on the back of the corrector plate. I'd say the coatings have got a purple hue to them. One or two small imperfections in the paint finish around the inside of the tube, probably caused by putting the cover onto the front. Not a big deal, but one or two small flecks there of paint. Other than that, looks good, solid. Hopefully in a future video, we'll take some shots through this. I'm looking forward to doing some planetary work with it with a webcam, and we'll get an idea for the optical performance of this. So that's it, Skywatcher Skymax 150 Pro Maksutov Telescope unboxed. Thanks for watching.